We delight in law of your word. We delight in son who was perfect from birth.
The small Central American country of Nicaragua has had a tumultuous history. During the 1970s and 80s, it was a key battlefront in the fight against the spread of communism in the Americas. As a result of decades of war, political unrest, and crippling economic conditions, there are many orphans in Nicaragua with no one to care for them. Enter a man with a revolutionary vision. For 24 years, Arturo Sanchez was a key figure in the Sandinista revolution as a right-hand man to Marxist leader Daniel Ortega. In 1989, Arturo had a radical conversion to Christ in the midst of working undercover for the communist movement in California. Now a Christian, Arturo returned to Nicaragua and began preaching the gospel on the streets and in the open-air markets. When he was done preaching, vendors and spectators would give offerings of food. One day while ministering, God moved on Arturo's heart to do something to care for the many homeless children around him. He would prepare the food that had been given as an offering and provide meals to the children while telling them about Jesus. 10 years ago, a man gave Arturo an old bus depot in Managua, which would become the first Casa Betesda orphanage. Currently, Casa Betesda has three sites. The original site in Managua houses up to 40 children under the age of 14. Located just a few miles away is a site that will eventually house children ages 14 to 17. The third location is in the city of Bluefields, which is located on the Caribbean coast of the country. Here, Casa Betesda already operates a school that serves 300 children from the community. It also offers free medical care with an on-site clinic.
Casa Betesda comes out of the scriptures in the book of John, chapter 5, of the Pool of Betesda. And it literally means house of grace. And this is one of the three orphanages that we are building here in Nicaragua. At this orphanage, we work with the Ministry of the Family. It is a government agency that oversees all orphanages and projects which are known as child protection centers. And Betesda House has been rated the last few years as one of the top orphanages here in Central America and even in the nation of Nicaragua. And we're very blessed and honored to have that privilege afforded to us. And the children, they come in from the government. The government, they pick them up, whether it's from the streets, they pick them up, and after they have screened them and found out what the status is, they bring them here to the orphanage here where they are assimilated into the family that we have here. They attend primary school. They go through their primary education school. We have a psychologist that works with them, that does different therapies with them and works with these children. And we have a staff here. They have a recreational facility also that they work with. They do their homework and they participate in a variety of activities both here and also at the farm, where they can also get involved in horticulture, in planting, in tree planting. And they do a variety of arts and crafts. They do dance, and they're involved in a variety of activities here. At Casa Betesda, we've been able to help literally hundreds of children, whether they've been here for a few days or whether they've been here for several years. And many of these, as they go on to 14 years of age, we have seen them leave their schools and continue on in their education. Some of them have even come back and they're employed now. Some are even self-employed. And so it's a real blessing to see how many of these children have even started families themselves. And so there are many success stories of how we've been able to help them and how this facility has been able to help them to become productive citizens in this nation. My name is Odili Ramirez.
Soy directora del centro.
And I am director of Betesda House. And we are working here with the children of Nicaragua. And I want to share one of the stories of one of the many children that we have. In the case of Joel, a child that's been here for over 3 years, almost 4 years here at Betesda House. And this child had been abandoned totally even by his mother.
Venía en un extremo de nutrición.
And he was undertold malnutrition.
Y el niño ya tiene, ¿verdad? Casi 4 años estar aquí. Él ha venido, para él, esta es su casa.
And this child now feels that this is now his home.
Hay veces bromeando le decimos, vamos a trasladarte a otro lugar si te portas mal. Un poquito necio. Él llora.
And when he, if he feels that he's going to be taken to another place, he will cry because he wants to stay here.
Porque él dice que él, esta es su casa y él vive aquí.
He said that he lives here and he wants to stay here.
Entonces él no se hace la idea de estar en otro lugar.
So he's not thinking of going anywhere else.
Porque él se siente que lo tratan bien.
Because he feels that he is well treated here in this place.
Aquí todos somos como familia para él.
He said to him, we're all family to him.
Aún el apóstol para ellos es como también un papá.
Yeah, all of us, he even considered me to be like a spiritual father to him.
My name is David Baird, and I'm the president of the Washington International Network. I recently had the privilege of visiting Casa Betesda. I was in Nicaragua and saw firsthand the work of Arturo Sanchez and the orphanages that are changing so many lives. Really, the whole mentality of a nation is being changed by a man and a team that have committed to making life better. I had a chance to talk with the psychologists, with the educators, with the medical people, with those volunteers who give their life for the children. And to see the transformations that have taken place is nothing short of a miracle. But now we need a miracle. We have taken it upon ourselves to spearhead the sponsorship of keeping Casa Betesda alive and keeping the vision to expand alive. We need your help. This is where you come in. As an individual, maybe your family, maybe you can take this to your civic group or your ministry or your community organization, perhaps your church or your business or your corporate sponsorship can step in and make life better for these orphans. For only $120 per month, your business, your family, your church, your organization can make such a difference. That $120 will feed a child, clothe a child, educate a child, bring medical help to a child, give the necessary environment for a child who has been left homeless to find his way back. I'm asking for your help. I ask you to prayerfully consider getting involved and becoming a sponsor for one of these precious children. Don't delay. I'm asking you to take a step in helping Casa Betesda. Your donation every month will keep these orphanages open and will bring more children to get the help that they need. I ask for your help today. You can fill out the form on the brochure that you may have, or you can go right to our website. And I ask that you would sponsor a child, join together with Artura, join together with this great team at Casa Betesda in making life better for the next generation.
Well, I want to thank you today, personally, for your involvement, for your support of Casa Betesda of Nicaragua. And I want you to know that your support is really making a tremendous difference. And you will have an opportunity to affect a life not only here, but for eternity. And they will be grateful to you forever. May God bless you, and I thank you so much.
Casa Betesda is the result of one man's vision to see the orphans of Nicaragua being cared for according to biblical mandates. The impact that Arturo has had on these young lives has been great. To continue and expand this impact, it will take the support of believers everywhere. You can support this ministry with a monthly gift of $120. $120 a month is all it costs to house, clothe, and feed a child at Casa Betesda. You can make a difference. Get involved with Casa Betesda today.